Everybody, what's up? It's Michael from the Game Haus, and today I am honored to be interviewing EG Svenskeren after a fiesta of a game, a 50-minute banger. So let's just get right into that. What was it like to be on the team there? What did it feel? Was it nerve-wracking the entire game, or was it more calm and collected?
I think it was pretty calm. Once we got the fourth dragon and they didn't get the soul, I kind of felt like we were in control and yeah, like we're going to outskill them. But I mean, obviously the game went on for a really long time and it was kind of close, but yeah, I mean, I didn't feel too stressed because it just felt like we're kind of winning the whole time. So yeah.
Did you get any flashbacks of the FlyQuest game when you weren't able to end at the Nexus at around the 40-minute mark? Because I interviewed Coach Dunn last week, and he was like, I don't know what they were doing during that. They should have been hitting the Nexus and all that. So
yeah, that was definitely scary being on the Nexus and not being able to end. And then they got Elder and Baron because we died. So yeah, I mean, I think looking at the replay, that was probably a way where we could end, but we just need to be more on the same page. So I think once we see that the game is like winnable, I think maybe we jump the gun and we just, yeah, we might do a little trolling on the Nexus.
Speaking of trolling, you have one of the most interesting to watch mid laners in the league, Jizuke, on your team. A lot of people will flame him for, you know, maybe some less valid reasons, but a lot of it is that he's more of a coin flippy player, right? That's how people describe him. So what is it like playing with someone, because obviously the mid jungle duo is very important, and that can be very feast or famine, and how does that affect you as a jungler?
I mean, it's always fun playing with Jizuke because he makes the game entertaining. So, I mean, I'm just here along for the ride, you know? If Jizuke's going in, I gotta go help him too, so.
It's Jizuke's really world and you're just in it?
Basically.
So, this game was a Cloud Soul, and I noticed that you guys let him up to three Drakes before you started to contest him. So is that a strategic thing around Cloud Souls and them being a little bit less important, maybe in comparison to the other Souls? Or is it just you guys didn't think you could win the fight until the three Drake point?
Yeah, so our draft didn't allow us to really contest early Dragons because we're getting pushed in all three lanes, and jungle matchup also is losing 1-1, so basically there was no winning except for if my two plays that I went for, if we're able to get something on those two plays, then we can probably start contesting earlier, but instead we died. So yeah, we just had to wait until later until we get some items.
When those two unfortunate early deaths happened, did you think you were out of the game at that point, or did you think the entire time there's a way I can get back in this despite being on Xin Zhao, who's a more, you know, aggressive early game champion?
I wasn't too worried, to be honest, because my champion scales really well. So I think the way Xin Zhao works right now is just he scales insanely well. So team fighting is just insane. So I don't feel too much pressure losing early game as Xin Zhao.
It's kind of ironic how he flipped how he used to be with the mini rework,
yeah,
huh?
The items and just the rework on him just makes his team fighting really, really good now.
And his W being the size of the lane, but let's not talk about that. I want to talk about impact on carries. This is something that we didn't see a lot out of EG last season. And so far we've seen it, I guess, two and a half times. So what is the mindset for EG playing around impact on these more aggressive carry style champions, such as the Akali from yesterday?
I mean, impact is just a really solid player. So no matter what champion you give him, he's going to do well, usually. But I mean, if you want to play a carry and he feels confident, then it's fine. Like, we just gotta give him attention and he's gonna do well no matter what. So I don't really mind too much what impact is playing. Obviously he's known for playing tanks, but he's really, really good on boosters too. So yeah.
So you guys came in today at the sixth place position, so obviously you had two wins this weekend and you could make it a 3-0 tomorrow. So what are you feeling about EG's placing in the standings right now, and how good do you think the chances are that you get in that upper echelon or the top six, that you don't start in losers for the, you know, summer playoffs?
Mm-hmm. I mean, I think we have a really good shot at making it into the upper bracket. I think we just gotta, I mean, if you look at our games in LCS so far, I think we could have been 5-0 right now. So I'm not feeling too much pressure. It's just we need to take the games seriously and actually improve from the losses. And yeah, I mean, as long as we do that, then I think we'll definitely be one of the top teams for playoffs.
So do you think last weekend was more of an exception rather than the rule with how things worked out?
Yeah. Okay. We should have definitely won the
Yeah, they were. Yeah, like I said, Dunn said that you guys really should have won all three of those games. And, you know, I think a lot of people would tend to agree that you were at the very least within them. That's all I got, man. Thank you very much for the interview. I appreciate you taking the time and good luck for the rest of the week. And what do you have to say to any EG fans on the way out?
Yeah, thank you guys for cheering for us. I know we lose a lot of games that we shouldn't lose, but I hope you guys still keep cheering for us.
All right, dude. Thank you very much. You have a good one.
Thank you.